Welcome to A Closer Look. I'm your host, Linda Fontaine. Today, my guest is Ashley Shelton, Communication and Program Director of the Town of Unicoi. She was here just a couple weeks ago, and she is back. You were talking about the Strawberry Festival. Now we're talking about the summer movie series.
We are. There's always something going on in Unicoi. We're known as a town that really enjoys our events, loves to get together as a community. Mm-hmm. And so, especially during the summer, we're always looking for ways to do that. Mm-hmm. And one way that we found that families really enjoy is our free summer movie series that do, you know, Movies in the Park. That event has actually historically been held at the Bogart Bowman Cabin, which is in our town, and it's a historic 1800s cabin, and we would put the movie screen up on in the field and let people just kind of bring their blankets and things mm-hmm. and camp out there. But of course, the pandemic changed some things us last year. So we actually moved that event to a fall event last year, and we did the movies in like September, October, November, and we did that in a drive-in format mm-hmm. at our Tourist Information Center, and it turned out to be a huge hit. It really worked well. We were able to, you know, we have the new Doug Hobson Buffalo Pavilion that was just dedicated last year, and that's where the concessions are housed. Mm-hmm. We pull people into the Mountain Harvest Kitchen parking lot, and the screen is up on the old historic CRR 1111 caboose that we restored a year ago.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, it really is a neat venue. Of course, we've got restrooms around back of the visitor center, but it's just a neat atmosphere. You get that drive-in, and we even had people last year that were kind of popping up the backs of vans, pulling up in trucks. And in those warmer months, they were sitting outside of the vehicles, of course, mm-hmm. social distancing. And so this year, when we talked about, you know, whether to move it back to the cabin or keep it up at the visitor center, mm-hmm. we decided that it was really something a little different and mm-hmm. that people seemed to love it. So we decided to keep it up there. And what that's going to do is actually allow us to have a little bit more fun when it comes toward our back to school blowout that we do before our August movie. Because, of course, we do a movie each month from June to August. And we're really excited about this year. I think mm-hmm. everybody's excited to get out and have things to do again.
Are you allowed to tell us what the movies are?
Unfortunately, our licensing doesn't allow us to tell what the movie is, but I can say that if you'll visit our website, exploreunicoi.com, or our Facebook page, we've got it posted in both of those places. In fact, our website has the all three movies that are playing this summer. Mm-hmm. And I will tell you this, that the one we're going to be playing next Friday night, June mm-hmm. 18th, is one of those classic fairy tale stories, but we're going to hear a different side. We're going to see the heroic side of a very favorite villain. So,
okay, I like that.
Yes.
I like that. I
think you know where we're going with that.
Yes,
and I think,
do.
You know, we did. We try to let the people choose what movies are playing. Mm-hmm. And so we put a couple weeks ago on our Facebook page quite a few, about 24 or 25 movies to choose from. And then we took the top three. So we're really excited that not just are we having these family-friendly movies, but they were chosen by the people. This is what they want to see. So.
Well, that's awesome. Now, what happens if it rains?
We actually do hold the event rain or shine. And of course, with it being a drive-in format, that gives us some flexibility. Because used to, we just had it outside. If it rained, it was kind of a we had to cancel thing. But now, the way the equipment will be set up and the projection equipment will be protected under the pavilion, so we can still show it in the rain. You can sit in your vehicles. You can also, if you want, we're encouraging people, you know, we're not under mask mandates anymore. We're not under the mm-hmm. COVID restrictions that we were last year. So people can bring their camping chairs. I'm going to be honest, there's a lot of rocky area because it's rock gravel parking lot. Mm-hmm. There are some green space areas kind of to the side. So if people want to bring a blanket or chairs and kind of sit up closer to the screen, we are going to be allowing that. And of course, the car is further back. And a lot of people will kind of do that tailgate thing. Mm-hmm. So I think that, you know, the good news is they'll have access to air conditioning mm-hmm. when we have some of these, you know, June and July hot
yes.
nights. Yeah. It gets a little warm at some of our movies.
I love that that's a drive-in format.
It's really neat. And it's just, you know, we're right there on the hill there in Unicoi at exit 32. And when you see that movie screen lit up at night and all these cars, it's really beautiful. It really is.
That is so fun. It's so reminiscent, you know, of back when. And I love that because there aren't that many drive-in theaters anymore. There's one or two, you know. So back in the day when I was little, it was just such a big treat. It was really fun.
It was. And, you know, I'm with you there. You don't see them as much anymore. And the great thing is we actually have the ability to play it through the FM car stereo. So you're going to have speakers outdoors where people can hear it if they're outside, but you can play it right through the car in the comfort.
That's even better because then you don't have to worry about if your speaker works or not or anything
exactly.
like that.
Exactly. Yeah. Or being too far away, because we do kind of park, you know, if you want a good space, we do encourage you to get there early. We always open the gates an hour before the movie. So the movie will be played at 9 o'clock, which is about the time it gets dark enough for us to show that movie. And the gates, the concessions will actually open at 8, and we have some great sponsors. Of course, Walmart comes on each year. Reinhart Food Services comes on, helps us out with some hot dogs and chili.
Nice.
We're going to have nachos and cheese, of course, candy bars, chips, drinks, things like that.
So your regular movie fare,
yes.
you know, stuff. And so this is, the first one's June 18th.
Yes.
The second one's July 16th, and the third is August 6th.
Yes.
So these are called Movies in the Park, Town of Unicoi. And concessions open up at 8 and the movies start at 9.
Now don't forget that August 6th, we're actually going to open up at 7 o'clock because we're going to do our back to school blowout before the movie.
What's that mean?
Oh, it is so much fun. If kids like water, this is where they're going to want to be on August 6th, because we do a slip and slide, which of course is going to be actually just slightly steeper than it was last year because of the venue. So we're going to have it'll be going down into a pool this year instead of just sliding down into the grass. And then we do a water balloon war that the kids absolutely love.
Oh,
they really
doesn't?
Love the water balloon war. I try to stay out of the way for that one, get them all set up, and then I move back. But we also have, you know, sprinklers and water games, sidewalk chalk, different fun things for the kids. Of course, as I said, the concessions will open at 7 o'clock that night as well. And we're hoping to maybe even bring on like an Italian ice vendor or somebody.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, we normally try to do a little treat for the kids somehow.
That'd be
and
nice.
The fire department will be there. The Unicoi volunteer Fire Department helps us with all of these events. They're a huge sponsor as far as providing a staff and making sure that everything's safe. So they'll be there with some fun things to hand out for the kids and of course to help us with the waterworks.
That you've got this pretty well planned out, it sounds like. This sounds wonderful.
We
so
like some fun.
ExploreUnicoi.com is where people can go for more information. But the first movie is June 18th, so that's coming up next Friday?
Next Friday night, yes. We'll open those gates at 8 o'clock, and we'll play that movie at 9, so we're really excited.
And we can't say the movie. And you know what makes that exciting, too, is that we're keeping it a surprise.
Yes.
But it's a good one. And these are all family-friendly.
All family-friendly. Our events, everything we do in Unicoi is about community and family and keeping things clean. So, yes, it will be a family-friendly movie.
So a G-rated movie.
In fact,
movie.
It's a Disney movie, so everybody loves a Disney movie.
You can say that.
Yes.
Okay, it's a Disney movie. That's going to be so much fun. And lots of concessions, so people don't have to bring food. I guess they could if they wanted to, but the concessions are open, so they don't have to worry about it. Bring your blanket or just sit in your car. I mean, it's coming through the car radio. That is pretty cool.
It is. It's a fun event, and we look forward to everybody just coming out and getting back to the way things used to be.
Okay, and so this is at the Tourist Information Center, right?
It is.
That's 106 Unicoi Village Place. That's June 18th. How many people are you expecting, Ashley?
You know, we've had anywhere from 50 to 100 people for a movie, well, 50 to 100 cars. It really depends. Now, we can only fit about 100, maybe a few more in our parking lots. So again, we do suggest getting there early. But as we're seeing this year, coming back from the pandemic, all of our events are garnering a lot more attendees than we're used to. So as you said, we were here talking a few weeks ago about the Wayne Scott Strawberry Festival. Mm-hmm. And people were desperate to get their strawberries this year.
Oh,
so
yeah.
We had, you know, on an event that normally garners 3,000 to 5,000 people, we had about 10,000 at that event. So.
Didn't you say it was just amazing how many people came out? Like you guys sold out?
Oh, the strawberries were sold out by 2 o'clock. They were gone very quickly. Of course, everybody loves Scott's strawberries.
Oh, yeah. I was at the store the other day and I said, oh, are we getting any more of those strawberries?
Mm-hmm.
They said, I don't know, with all the rain we've had.
Yes.
They said that kind of shortened the strawberry season, and I was like, no.
I know. Well, people were out, and of course, there wasn't just strawberries. It was so much fun. We had bands on the stage all day long, and people really seemed to enjoy. We had a lot of new people that had not played on our festival stage before, and that seemed to go over well. So it was just an amazing day. Our vendors were happy. People waited a little bit longer in traffic, but we're working on that for Freedom Fest.
Oh, good. So. And speaking of Freedom Fest, what's that?
Well, Freedom Fest is our annual 4th of July celebration. We do that every year on the 4th of July, so it will be held on Sunday, July 4th. 4th. And of course, Johnson City is not holding their fireworks this year. And of course, we had quite a bigger turnout for Strawberry Festival than we were used to. So we're expecting a good size crowd, 10,000 or plus for our Freedom Fest this year. And we've got a big name band we're going to be bringing. So.
And you're not going to tell me, are you?
Well, I might be able to tease that it has something to do with 80s music.
Oh, I love that. 80s music was voted number one decade, 80s then 70s, and I like them both probably equally. I love
the
70s, probably a little bit more, but the 70s and 80s are just, to me, the best. That's when bands were bands, you know?
Yes, and it's music that seems to be, it seems to cross generations, you know? Mm-hmm. The grandmother's dancing to it, the mom's dancing to it, and the kids are dancing to it.
My kids love 80s music.
Oh, I know, me too.
You know, they love it. I love all this information. We'll have to have you come back on to talk about Freedom Fest.
We will, because we're going to have a lot to say about that. Parking is going to be the biggest thing. So by the time I come back to talk about Freedom Fest, we're going to have all that laid out so that people can get the information up front and not get stuck in traffic. That's what our goal is.
All right. So let's go over this again. We have the Town of Unicoi Movies in the Park.
Yes, our Movies all in the Park. We're doing Drive-In at the Caboose.
Drive-In at the Caboose. There's all kinds of names for this, isn't there?
There is.
Summer Movie Series, Movies in the Park, Town of Unicoi, June 18th, July 16th, and August 6th. Put those on your calendar. And the August 6th is a little extra special back-to-school blowout at the Tourist Information Center. They're all there. 106 Unicoi Village Place. Concessions open at 8. Movies are at 9. And they're all family fun, family appropriate movies.
Yes.
And if you want more information, just go to exploreunicoi.com.
Mm-hmm. Awesome. Or you can always give us a call. Our visitor center is staffed Monday through Friday, 8 to 5. And if we can't get your call right away, we will call you back by the end of the day. So all the information you want is at your fingertips.
You're awesome. Thank you, Ashley, for being here.
Thank you for having
us. Thank you for joining us. This is A Closer Look.
Thank you.